not, you're not really understanding what happens to your avatar at the state of what you consider, oh, I'm high now. You know, what separates soul era, or they start to talk a little deeper after that spirit of that plant gets inside them. But you must find out why today if you don't already know. When this is why, listen, when Jim Morrison said, whoever controls the media controls the mind. Okay? I'll repeat. Jim Morrison, this is the power of marijuana. He wasn't talking like this before he hit the weed. He hit the weed. He hit the Zaza. He hit that thing. You feel me? All of a sudden, whoever controls the media, shit strong, ain't it? Whoever controls the media controls the mind.
It's Barry.
Blue Zittles, but Blue Zittles. It tastes like blueberry, though. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that shit tastes good. So look, right? Jim Morrison said, whoever controls the media controls the mind. All right? That's a fact. He said this in the 1950s. Now, why are we focusing on what Jim Morrison said? And keep in mind, Jim Morrison was white. He was a human being. Okay? Jim Morrison said, whoever controls the media controls the mind. That's a motherfucking fact. Jim Morrison, they actually killed Jim Morrison. All right? Y'all might not know this. Go look him up. Jim Morrison had some quotes on him. Like, that was a deep ass human being. But why was Jim Morrison so deep? He was for world peace too. He was like John Lennon of the Beatles. John Lennon is another human being that was for world peace. He was killed. He is another one that was like, why? What do John Lennon and Jim Morrison have in common? They was getting high as shit. John Lennon was with Yoko Ono. They were smoking good weed. Yoko Ono is an Asian. That was his wife. They were smoking good ganja. All right? Jim Morrison. All right? They were smoking good ganja. All right? And they was, you hear me? They was vibrating super high. Somebody said Jim Carrey. Yes, Jim Carrey smokes a lot of weed. You see the shit he talks about in his interviews. All right? You got to understand why. It's because you got to know the history of cannabis. Cannabis, because this is originally called cannabis, okay? Cannabis. Yeah, that blueberry strong, too. That's all I taste is blueberry. Cannabis originates from the Canis Major star system. This is the cosmic history of cannabis, okay? First off, cannabis is all feminine. All plants are feminine energy. I don't know if you knew that. Yes, most jazz musicians were smoking cannabis. Cannabis is feminine energy. It's not masculine. All plant life is feminine energy. I don't know if you knew that, but all plants are feminine energy. I repeat that. All plants are feminine energy. Now, you got plants that they try to tell the public are masculine. But any plant that is masculine, if it is masculine, it's because it's a synthetic plant. Understand, eugenics. When I said in my song God Talk, they study eugenics, tried cloning my image, right? That's what I was talking about. Like, they've cloned everything on the planet, down to the plants. If you go watch the movie Avatar, what was the first thing they was doing when they was on Pandora? Avatar is all about us. I've told y'all this since last year, right, publicly. Avatar is about us, all right? Avatar is about how the planet looked, our planet looked when they first got here. And that's why when they first land on Pandora, okay, the first thing they was doing was studying the genetics, the roots. They needed samples. They were trying to get root samples of the plants, of all the plants there, all right? Because if they can get a sample of the plant's genetics, then they can clone the plant. Just like if they get a sample of your genetics, they can clone you. Okay? Let me repeat that. They needed a sample of the plant when they landed on Pandora. Why? So that they can get the genetics. So that they can clone, replicate the genetics. Now, if you know the history of our planet, you know that everything on the planet has been cloned at this point. But you, if you know the true history, you also know that why are the oppressors so obsessed with cloning things? Because we cloned them. Okay? Zeus cloned them. Who was Zeus? Zeus was a brother. He was black, like me and you. Carbonated being. He wasn't white. Now, he goes by many names. Some people books, he's Satan. In some people books, he's Odin. In some people books, he's Jesus. In some people books, he's Prometheus. If you go study the Sumerian texts and tabloids, he's Enki and Enlil. This one I'm going to be talking about the Akashic Records later, but just to kind of tap in that. When I'm talking to y'all about our information, I can go to any of their history and tell you who they named them as. Because this is what I was sent to do. I'm channeling right now. I don't got no books in front of me, no nothing. Anytime I talk to y'all, it's coming from here. I'm channeling. So what does channeling mean? That means that I'm basically going inside my genetics. Because my genetics is everywhere throughout the multiverse, and so is yours. I'm going inside my genetics, and I'm going directly to the cosmic source, which is in me, to pull out these memories for you to remember. This is what I've been doing since day one, since I started going live and teaching publicly the last 2 years. It's called channeling. You can do the same thing. But you have been taught not to trust yourself. You have been taught that if it's not coming from somebody else, then it's not validated. So you're cutting yourself off from all these memories that's already sitting inside you. We should be able to laugh about these memories that I'm telling you. This shouldn't be nothing that you just hearing for the first time. We should be laughing about this shit and remember the days type conversation. But a lot of us are hearing it for the first time, or so it feels like we're hearing it for the first time, because we had our memories bleached. Cannabis is something that we created on the Canis Major star system. You got to remember that. You're an ancient being. You have to remember that. This is the true reason why the oppressors attacked it. The oppressors have attacked cannabis, nigga. It's illegal. They just now trying to make it legal. All right? Cannabis was attacked from the moment they got here. It was deemed illegal. They just now making it legal. And the weed, and when they saying it's legal now, that's through the dispensaries. And this shit is getting smoked through dispensaries, and even the shit they growing, even if you getting it off the streets and you thinking that your weed is different because you didn't get it out of dispensary, you're fooling yourself. All the weed that's being grown, they have tampered with the genetics of the plant. To understand why, you have to understand cannabis. Cannabis is one of the most powerful plant sources throughout the entire multiverse. Cannabis. Remember now, to you it's just Zaza. To you it's just a backwood. It's just a king palm. It's just a whatever you rolling in. But you're forgetting that that is an actual plant, and all plant has what? Life, mind, body, and soul. So when you're taking in the smoke, what you think is smoke from the plant that you're burning, you're fusing your spirit with the spirit of the plant. This is why you start to experience the feeling that make that you call I'm high. Okay, this whole feeling that you're feeling of, oh, I think I'm high, you're not really high. Right? Your spirit is connecting with the spirit of the plant. And once you connect with the spirit of the plant, now she starts to unlock genetics within you. So this is why Bar Marley said, when you smoke the herb, it reveals yourself to you. Now, you know how a lot of y'all get paranoid? People get paranoid when they smoke. Everybody don't get paranoid when they smoke, though. Why is that? Some people smoke, they get paranoid. Other people smoke and don't get paranoid at all. You know why? Because like Bob Marley said, it reveals you to yourself. The cannabis has been infused with the spirit of truth. You got to remember what Ashe is. Ashe is the universal life force that connects us all. But what is Ashe? The Ashe is the dark matter energy. The photon energy. The chemical compounds that were used to create things within different planets. The nutrients that was used to create this physical realm that we experience. That's all a part of the Ashe. The quantum energies. The plasma energies. The gamma radiation. That's all a part of Ashe. And the plant was infused with the spirit of truth. Just like certain crystals you wear are infused with the spirit of truth. So if something is infused with the spirit of truth, your third eye will be open. Right? So the cannabis was infused with the spirit of truth. So when you smoking it, this is why whatever you think about, the truth is going to come to you. Even if it's about yourself. So this is what everybody experiences, paranoia. Because you're not right within. You're probably going through something. It's probably something that don't sit right with you. So now when you smoking, you thinking you're just smoking, but you're connecting your spirit with the spirit of a truthful plant. Each plant is not going to speak enlightenment and truth to you. But cannabis does, though. You got a lot of different species of plants. Remember, the plants alone are a species. You have trillions of different species of plants, and they all have different jobs, and they have all different things that they do. Plants are not just limited to this goddamn planet. This is the headquarters of the plant species, though. Just like Xylanthia, it's the headquarters of the Anunnaki gods. This planet, yeah, drop the nines if y'all understand what I'm saying. This planet is the headquarters of the species for plants. But the species of plants don't just stop right here on this planet. Plants is on every planet. You got plant life on every planet, in every galaxy, in every dimension, everywhere. They just like us. They everywhere. This is why we one with the plants. We created plants, though. But plant life is everywhere. Even in the seas. You go 10,000 leagues under the motherfucking sea, and you're going to find plants. You understand what I'm saying? Plants are a species. Okay? So when you're talking about cannabis, you're talking about a certain type of plant. Okay? So when we talking about this species called cannabis, this plant called cannabis, which is a part of the plant species, that particular plant was created in the Canis Major star system. Cannabis does not come from Earth. Cannabis does not come from Earth. You don't come from Earth. Shit, the human beings don't even come from Earth. Nothing on Earth is from Earth. Everything on this planet was brought here. Okay, this was our planet that we, the gods, were building up to replicate our headquarter planet. This was like our baby. This is Planet Kai. This is Tiamat, which is also why in the Eternals movie, they froze Tiamat. They killed Tiamat, didn't they? But we'll talk about that in the Eternals lecture. We'll save that for that lecture coming up in 2 weeks. But the name of this planet anciently was Planet Kai or Tiamat. And I've been telling y'all that too way before they ever came out with a fucking Eternals movie. Think it's a coincidence that in the movie Eternals, the shit was called Tiamat. The Celestial was called Tiamat, and it was planted where on Earth? We'll get to that though when that lecture comes up. We talking cosmic history right now. I'm giving you your cosmic history. Because you want to believe you're African-American. You want to believe that old La La Land story about you was in Africa and that our history goes no further than Africa. That's a fucking lie. Africa in itself is a European name. So what is you talking about? Africa ain't even named Africa, nigga. So what is you talking about? When you say Africa, when you get the name of them tribes, you speak in Spanish. You speak in European languages, man. European languages. See what I'm saying? They didn't just invade the Americas, motherfucker, in the West. Pre-colonialization, when the Spanish colonized us, when Spain colonized us, if you want to call them the Spaniards, that ain't nothing but another name for the reptilians and Pleiadians, man. But when they colonized us, man, they didn't just hit the Americas, dog. So stop feeling like y'all know something when people like, oh, well, in Africa. If you got to even say in Africa, you not on the vibration I'm on, man. That means you a student in this class. See, when I go sit in the class with elders, I'm students in their classes. But in this class, you a motherfucking student. You in the comments and you even, well, in Africa, in this religion, in this tradition, what were they before? But before they were called Africans, what were they? And who are those people that's called Africans? Those are our brothers and sisters. That's us. That's still us. That's still us. All right. So when you start saying Africa or in Cuba or anciently in Brazil, you can't go that anciently if you're going to call it Brazil. You're not getting ancient enough in this motherfucker for me. When you get to saying, well, anciently in Africa, you're not ancient enough because you're saying Africa. We going beyond Africa in here. This is the University of Cosmic Intelligence. We in the cosmos. So before there was ever a motherfucking planet, it was the cosmos. That's the divine information I bring to the planet. This is cosmic intelligence, man. This ain't no Earth shit. You see what I'm saying? This shit, before it was a planet, it was a cosmos. Remember that. Before it was Earth, Mars, Uranus, Venus, a galaxy, a universe, a planet around any of that shit, it was the cosmos. We was in the cosmos first before we ever came into this physical density. I'm talking to you on a cosmic level. You see what I'm saying? Do you know, it's 9 different multiverses. And one multiverse alone has 9 universes. And each universe has 999 galaxies within it. And each galaxy has 999 planets within that galaxy. And each planet has 9 realms, man. And that's in one multiverse. It's 9 multiverses, which all 9 multiverses are being ran by us on our home planet, Xylanthia. Series X. So this is why I can tell you about exactly what planet this comes from. I was here. Or should I say I was there? The Cannabis Major Star System. Go watch my YouTube lecture on galaxies and on the truth about constellations. This is why I gave a lecture about the truth about constellations. Shout out to South Africa. I see y'all in here. This is why I gave a truth about the constellations, a lecture about the constellations, so that you can understand that what constellations really are. They are really galaxies. They hid the galaxies from you by naming them constellations. Even I even told you, your zodiac sign is considered a constellation. So if your zodiac sign is considered a constellation and the constellations are galaxies, then you know what galaxy you was in before you got here. G. Rico, what it do, God? Yeah, you know, they got it raining real bad right now in Georgia. But that's a whole nother lecture. The ancestors sent me to talk to y'all about the cannabis right now. Okay? So, you have a group of beings. Okay? You need to know about the beings who created cannabis. So, let me tell you about them. There are a group of beings that exist. All right? And they are the ones responsible for creating the cannabis. All right. These beings are gods, though. But we are gods. If you can understand that the gods is the name of our species, you will then understand why the Africans had so many gods. Go to African tradition. They had many gods. Go to look at Egyptian tradition. If you do want to look, use the earth schools to as a source of reference. Because if you want to be truly enlightened, you can't use these earth schools. You got to use the spiritual schools, which are within you. I'll repeat that. If you wish to be truly enlightened, you cannot use the earth schools that have been placed around you to misguide you, to mislead you. You have to go to the spiritual universities, and they lie within you. They don't call you. They only lie within you. See what I'm saying? The spiritual universities. So, we are all gods. You go look at the Mayans tradition, they had many gods. Go look at the Incas, they had many gods. Go look at the Aztecs, the Cherokee, any tribe, they had many gods. Go look at any African tradition, the Zulu, the Yoruba tribes, they had many gods. Go look at the Chinese, the Japanese, many, many, many gods. Then you get over here to Western Europe, you get over here to Europeanized shit, and then it's just one god all of a sudden. You must ask yourself, why do they have many gods? Because we are everywhere. We are everything. We have many jobs. Right? If I'm telling you we are all gods, that makes it click more why they have many gods. Ain't it many motherfuckers walking around you right now? So if you could look at these other black and Latino people as gods for what they really are, then you will see, yeah, we do got many motherfucking gods. Now, you not doing your fucking job because you're a god. You down here acting like a human being, though. This what American gods was about. American gods was about our black ass, y'all. Now, they flat out mocked us in American Gods. The whole theme, it was what? How did the black goddess act? Boy, she was a whole goddess. But how the fuck was she living, though? When she forgot she was a goddess. Remember that? She walked around as a bum on the street. You see what I'm saying? Who you think they was trying to show you about American Gods? They was talking about your ass. All these gods in what we now call America, they don't even know they gods. They don't even know they goddesses because we got them under these spells. That's what American Gods was all the fucking about. That's why they even named it that. And then they even told you how Jesus wasn't real. And they showed you how those gods that they got us to worship, we gave them our God power by worshiping them. All them gods, Ishtar, all them gods they had created didn't have no power without us worshiping them. Remember that? He told them that in American Gods. And they told you how to control the weather. When he made shadow make it snow. What'd he tell them do? Close your eyes. Keep saying snow. Keep saying it. The whole ride he was riding that day, he kept telling them, just keep saying it. Keep saying it. Just keep saying it. So he did it the whole ride. By the end of the night, it was snowing. Yeah, we got that type of power. So we the gods, right? And it was a group of us that created the cannabis. Cannabis was created by the Canna Empire. All right, so what's the Canna Empire? You have many different empires in the cosmos. Nevertheless, they still gods at the core. Unless they are an extraterrestrial race. See what I'm saying? In the cosmos, you either going to be an Anunnaki god or you're an extraterrestrial race. Or you are an Ashe being. Ashe beings don't take on bodies. In the cosmos. They just spirit. They never take on no form of density. So this is where you get your principalities from that they speak of in the Bible. For we war not against flesh and blood. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. Spiritual wickedness in high places. Right? But you might have thought when they said principalities, they just meant like the principle of something. The principles of a situation or something. No. Principalities are an actual group of powerful Ashe beings that exist. Some are before the split because it wasn't a split at first. We was all on one side. But it's just like that GDBD war in Chicago or the Crips and the Bloods. GDs and BDs was one at first. Then they split. War broke out and they split. Some people went GD. Some people went BD. And that war been going on since the 70s. In Chicago. It ain't just started with Chief Keef and Lil Durk in it. Shit been going on. Right? Just like with the Crips and Bloods. They've been warring forever, right? Since the 50s. So it was the same thing with us in the cosmos. We were all one. We were all one. And then once we fell out with our brother Zeus, who you know down here is Satan, that was the split. That was the war in heaven. That's the war in heaven they talked about. That was the great split. Some of us niggas started choosing sides. Just like down here, right? A lot of y'all caught up in all the little dirt NBA Youngboy fake industry beef, right? And you got fans choosing sides. You got industry people choosing sides. No different than with Pac and Biggie, right? Whole time it ain't shit but a setup for one or both to be sacrificed eventually. Dirk did a lot more for these people than YB, so I can see them trying to sacrifice Youngboy through this fake beef with Dirk. See what I'm saying? Dirk then sacrificed a lot of motherfuckers for them. Period. Fuck all that fan shit y'all be caught up in. I'm going to keep it real over Rich. You know what I'm saying? YB ain't really did too much sacrificing like Dirk did. So what's going to happen is they're going to use the YB Dirk beef to sacrifice YB. And then they're going to require a bigger sacrifice from Dirk because they never happy. That's why I tell people in the industry, don't fuck with them. Even if you sacrificing for them, you can still end up a sacrifice. Don't never forget that because you still the enemy to them. Diddy, all y'all that be doing shit for the elites, don't ever forget that they'll sacrifice y'all ass too in a heartbeat. Happens a lot. They'll use one of you house Negroes to sacrifice a million motherfuckers, then 30 years later sacrifice your ass. That's how they did R. Kelly. Used him to do a whole bunch of dirt for years. Then turned around and sacrificed his ass. So I'm trying to get y'all to see, man. You can be a house Negro all day, but at the end of the day, you still a Negro to them. See what I'm saying? Let me repeat that to you house Negroes. You could be a house Negro and help mass all day. You can wear a million wires on and come around to my reunion to act like you on our side, but you work with the CIA. You can get in these lives to act like you in the university the whole time you've been paid by the CIA and the FBI to infiltrate this university. Right? You can go sacrifice people in the industry to get ahead all you want. But at the end of the day, that's all house Negro activity. But never forget that you're still a Negro. You're still a house Negro. Just a good house Negro. That doesn't make you them. It's business with them. Never personal, man. You feel me? So, I'm saying all that to say, that's going to be the next step with them. Right? But, that's because sacrifices is taking place. Energy is being exchanged for offerings. Because it's real spiritual warfare. This is why you got to know about the cannabis and who created it. A group of us created it. Cannabis comes from the The fuck? Cannabis comes from the Canis Major star system. The fuck is this? Cannabis comes from the Canis Major star system. Created in the Canna Empire, you feel me? Like, now the beings that live within the Canna Empire, these are beings that have direct ties to certain vast amounts of energy that other individuals don't. Yeah, I told y'all screen recording say it a lot. But the beings that exist in the Canna Empire, right? They have access to infinite amounts of energy that the other beings don't. They also have access to certain botanical information the other beings don't. You know what I'm saying? So this allowed them to be highly advanced when it comes to the plant kingdom in ways that other beings are not. So in the Canna Empire, basically the job that needed to be done was we wanted to have a direct connection to intelligent life. All right. So we represent those forms of intelligent life. But also human beings represent a form of intelligent life because they were made in our image. So they are still unlike any other beings throughout the cosmos. Although they have the recessive genetics, although they are not organic, they were still made in our image. So goddamn it, if you make something in Superman image, he ain't gonna be Superman, but shit, he gonna come close, right? Just like Kobe, right? Kobe, you look at Kobe Bryant. Let's lose Kobe Bryant. You could say Kobe Bryant was made in Michael Jordan image. Kobe would never be Jordan, right? Now you got a whole generation of motherfuckers that believe that Kobe Bryant was better than Jordan. I'm just using this as an example. But then you got a generation of us who seen Jordan play and Kobe play and could clearly tell you, no, he's not better than Jordan. But if you never seen Jordan play and you only grew up on Kobe, then of course you're going to feel like Kobe better than Jordan. That makes sense because he was damn near close to him. Mm-hmm. Just like if you never, it's a group. Even if we know the NBA, we know the NBA, these are robots, we know all that. We know all that, but we just using it for class sake, for lecture sake, we know all that. So for anybody thinking like, well, I thought you said they were Mach 5. They are Mach 5 synthetic robots. I still stand on that. All right. That's why you seen Richard Jefferson taking my video and posting it to his TikTok page just to say that this is not true. Well, goddamn it, Richard Jefferson, if it isn't true, you're a fucking basketball legend, millionaire. Why are you taking time to respond to some crazy YouTuber on YouTube that's lying? Right? Exactly. Okay. So we know all that. But what I'm saying is it's a group of us that believe in LeBron James. It's better than fucking Kobe. And that's just what they're going to believe. And they got the right to believe that because they grew up watching LeBron. And LeBron has done some great things on that court. Let's remove all the Mach 5 synthetic robot shit. We know that. But for lecture's sake, y'all with me? For lecture's sake, because I'm making a point right now. Just making a point. Okay. So it's the same thing with the fucking human beings, right? They were made in our image. So goddamn it, we Jordan. They like Kobe. You know what I'm saying? They ain't gonna never get 6 rings. You feel me? They'll never go 6-for-6 in the finals. You know what I'm saying? They'll never win MVP and Defensive Player of the Year in the same year with a scoring title and a dunk contest. They ain't gonna do shit like that. They'll never come into the league and be told that they can't that they can't really score. And then they increase their scoring. And then when they increase their scoring, now the league say that they don't stick defense. And then the next year, they go out and win Defensive Player of the Year. They'll never do shit like that, but they'll win some rings. Y'all get what I'm trying to say? They'll win some rings because they were made in our image. You know what I'm saying? They'll win a dunk contest. They'll have a fadeaway jumper just like us. Kobe emulated Michael Jordan jumper to the T, but never forget who he learned it from, though. Without Jordan, you don't get Kobe. Okay, fuck what you say, so how can Kobe be better than Jordan? You know what I'm saying? You don't get Kobe. What if there's no Jordan? You don't get LeBron without Kobe and Magic. You know what I'm saying? Which really LeBron was more like Magic Johnson anyway. So he was never supposed to even been in a Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant conversation anyway. He's like Magic Johnson. You know what I'm saying? So that's the point I'm making with the human being connection to the gods. Okay. So this is why they were able to do what they were able to do. Human beings are still powerful beings, y'all. They not as powerful as us, But it's, once again, it's just like when Kobe played Jordan in the fucking All-Star game. When Jordan got in the All-Star game in 1998 and he went against Kobe and he went in the game on some, I'm Jordan, you Kobe, you a new nigga type shit. What Kobe do to him? What'd he do to him? He was busting Mike ass. I'm talking about 98, Kobe first All-Star game, they had to sub him out. He was, because Mike was retiring that year. He was fucking Mike up. When Mike came back and he came back on some I'm Jordan shit and he told Kobe, why you got my shoes on? You don't feel them shoes yet. What did Kobe do to Jordan the next game in 2002? He gave his ass 55 in the first half, right? Because Jordan went out there forgetting that this man been studying you. This is your pupil. Same thing with the human beings, y'all. We can never underestimate them. They've studied us. They study us to mimic us. They watching the footwork. They looking at how we created everything. That's why they kept all the books. That's why they stay excavating, digging things up out the ground. Right? So I'm just pointing out the shit out to show you that what I'm saying cosmically about them being created by us is a real thing. I'm just pointing out examples. But because they lack DEA. I just did a lecture on DEA on YouTube. Go watch it if you haven't. The difference between deoxyethyric acid and DNA. They lack DNA. So they have that animal genetic. And the animal genetic is the reason why the gods and goddesses that's from the Canna Empire, that's located in the Cannabis major star system, created cannabis. They infused it with the Ashe of enlightenment, with the Ashe of peace. I'm just connecting dots. You feel me? So by them infusing this with the Ashe of enlightenment and peace, they brought this plant down to the planet to give to the human being species. First and foremost, to decalcify the pineal gland. Now the pineal gland, why is this considered the third eye? And the pineal gland is called what? The eye of truth. It's your spiritual eye for you to see things clearly for what they are. Okay, it's not really an eye. It's more like technology that has been placed inside of your avatar. It's like a camera into the spiritual realm that's placed inside your avatar. So you know how, like when you get your car and when you go to throw it in reverse, they got the camera in the motherfucking license plate so you can see what's behind you. Okay, so this is a part of the avatar. We gave these avatars these cameras, the third eye. So you throw that bitch in reverse, you ain't got to turn around. I see what's behind me. I can see what's in front of me. If I turn this camera on, I can see everything for what it truly is. That's what the third eye is. But guess what? While we being non-ether beings full of Ashe, we come down pre-programmed with this because we are the creators of all life. So we come with it automatically. But when the human beings were created, they have one, but it's gel shed. It's gel shed. So this plant has nutrients that works like a cleanser that's able to cleanse the pineal gland. It cleanses their pineal so they can see, so they can remember too the war. So look at it like having a dirty windshield, or it's raining outside, it started raining hard. If you don't turn the windshield wiper on, you can't see. So the marijuana acts as a windshield wiper to their pineal gland. It cleanses it. It decalcifies it. Because it's calcified. So it cleanses, it opens, it cleanses. Now they can see clearly. But it don't just do that to them. Because we infused it, it takes us to higher levels within ourselves. Because we have also a lot of DEA, which they call the God gene, or this is why they list us metahumans, right? The meta gene, which we have, which is really DEA. It is a lot of those memories are clogged too. They closed off a lot of them, but they couldn't. And when they closed them, y'all, they didn't delete them. This is programming inside of you. They can't delete the program. They can just disrupt the file. You get what I'm saying? So like, that's why they lie to us. That's why they take us through programming. They can't delete the program. They can't erase the program. That's why they have to program us. If they were able to erase the program, then they wouldn't take us through school to program us. They wouldn't lie to you about the truth about cannabis, having you thinking it's just some fucking plant that's illegal. They wouldn't do all that because you already programmed. So they have to reprogram you. which is disrupting your file. This is an electromagnetic realm. We are electromagnetic beings. This is what an aura is. So when they're lying to you, they're not erasing your programming. They are actually just disrupting your file. Okay? So when they disrupt the files, when they disrupt your files, all right? When they disrupt your files, now you can't access those files. So those files are certain levels of enlightenment, truth, shit like, hey, did you know that cannabis comes from the Cannabis Major Star System? Well, yes, you do. That's a file inside of your genetics that has been disrupted with reprogramming. So if I come and remind you about that file, I'm basically cleansing your file out. I'm cleaning it. The same way you got a computer and you got to cleanse it of viruses, I'm cleaning y'all viruses out when I'm giving y'all this information. So the virus, it's a virus removal because I'm giving you enlightenment. It's a virus removal. So it's cleaning the virus. So the viruses that's in your files start getting clean and then you start remembering because the files are able to play now. They are able to run smoothly. So these files that are running smoothly, they come to you as memories and you be like, oh yeah, that makes sense. Oh yeah, that do. Now all of a sudden you be like, oh yeah, that makes sense. Oh yeah, that do add up. That do feel right in my soul. You get it? You get what I'm saying? Somebody said, how do you cleanse these files? You cleanse the files with enlightenment. Enlightening yourself. Sitting in these lectures. Meditation. That's how you cleanse the files. I just said that. But maybe you didn't hear me, so I repeat it. So you got to understand that also the marijuana also helps to cleanse these files. So when you smoking that weed, this is why even a dumb motherfucker starts seeming smart as shit when they smoking. We ain't gonna really say nobody's dumb, but some people remember more, some people remember less. So those who remember less, we call them dumb, but they really not dumb. They just don't remember. Okay. So you could take a motherfucker that could seem like dumb as a box of rocks. He hit the weed. Now all of a sudden he got some shit to say. You get what I'm saying? Now all of a sudden he got some shit to say. You be like, man, give me the weed, man. Your ass tripping, right? He not tripping. It's cleansing out files. Now, with the human beings, it completely cleans their shit out. That's why you seen Jim Morrison, oh, whoever controls the media controls the mind. Saying shit like that. You seen John Lennon putting out a lot of positive energy in his interviews. They had to kill him off. You start seeing that type of shit. A lot of people don't know. John F. Kennedy was smoking weed on the low. What was he on? They had to knock him off. Right. Any human being you come across that smoke weed, they don't be fucking racist. They be cool as shit, nigga. We just shot a video. Shit with an actor. We had some human beings on the set. Actors, actresses, casters. All that and all they had smoked weed. They was cool as shit. They wasn't on no racist shit. None of that. Shit, one of them. Shit, you feel me? Because of this. Because of that. Now, understand this. The elites don't control all the human beings. Remember, they are not even in the clique. They just got the human beings thinking that they are in the clique. Remember that now. This is why they made weed illegal. Because of what it does to our files. We getting deeper now. Let's connect the dots. Now do you see why they made weed illegal? Shit ain't even a regular plant. It's a fucking weapon. If you know how to use it. They made it illegal just for that reason. Now, if you understand that this is a fucking cosmic weapon that connects you to source, how about smoking a blunt and then going to meditate? You don't believe me? Try it. Smoke some weed, go into meditation, and then you come back and tell me what was revealed to your ass. And you can apply that to anything. Smoke some weed and start cleaning the house. Boy, you're going to clean the fuck out the house. You're going to clean the fuck out the house. Smoke some weed and start cleaning the house. You're going to clean that house like you ain't never cleaned it a day in your motherfucking life. You hear me? Smoke some weed and go hoop. Boy, I used to get high and go hoop and be busting niggas' ass out there. I'm dropping dimes because, you know, me, I'm like Chris Paul when I'm on the court. I need like 20 assists, assist and steals. That's what I'm on. You feel me? If you step up, I can break you down. My first step quick, I'm breaking you down. You feel me? But I'm like Chris Paul. Boy, I'm dishing. I'm dropping dimes. Break you down. And then when y'all are making the defense collapse, and then I'm dropping the dime. That's how I hoop. I know my role on the court. I'm only 5'8". I ain't trying to get out here, nigga, put up 60. You feel me? I'm fast. I'm going to get all my points off steals on the fast break anyway. I'm gone. I'm penetrating. I'm dishing. You feel me? All day. Right? I smoke the weed. I get out there. I'm like Jason Kidd. I'm seeing all type of passing lanes. I'm dishing all type of shit. I'm damn near off the elbow passes off the weed. Try it working out. No lie. Try it. Hit the weed and go work out. You're going to work out like you ain't never worked out before. I used to do that to hit the weed. What? Sets. I'm going crazy on the sets. Soon as I hit the weed, I'm talking about off the weed. Soon as I hit the weed, soon as I hit the weed, I'm in the gym like this. Diamonds. You hear me? Locked hands, real diamonds, nigga, honey, straight up. Off the weed, then fresh out the diamonds. I ain't even coming down. I'm wides. Real wides. Locking loads. If you ever been to jail, you know that shit don't count if you ain't locking and loading. I'm out here with it. Wides. You hear me? Off the gas. You hear me? I damn near can hit 100 straight now. Fuck is you talking about? I damn near do 100 right now. Fuck is you talking about? You hear me? You know what I'm saying? You see that bounce? I ain't nowhere near tired. You see what I'm saying? Off the weed, though. I'm just saying, though. Now, guess what? Niggas talking about weed make you lazy. Boy, this shit dangerous. You see my little sister, Shakari Richardson? She light up. She leaving niggas out there. Leaving them. They had to make it a steroid. How is weed a steroid when weed should make you slower? They say weed make you more tired, make you slower. I'm just connecting dots. But what happened though? Now we ain't Lil Sis. Shout out to Shakari Richardson. Cause now she followed me. That's Lil Sis. I fucks with her. We be chopping it up. Shout out to she in the university. Shout out to Shakari Richardson. You feel me? We know they was trying to get you to sell out. You ain't want to sell out, so they try to play with you. But what I'm saying is this, nigga. This thing right here, they say she lit this. You hear me? We not saying she did it. We saying what they said. So don't nobody try to flip it. Because I fuck with Shakari and her whole family. Shout out to them. Nah, for real, that's family. They try to say she lit this. Lit this. Gave a nigga one of these. You hear me? That's what they said. That's what they said. She was smoking. She hawking shit. Leaving shit. You hear me? Leaving shit. Leaving shit. She was getting high. She's cheating. Why would y'all connect weed to her cheating? I'm just connecting dots. And remember, they made it illegal. Y'all don't get it, though. This shit do something different to us. Y'all don't even get that what I'm trying to show. For real. For real, though, like. Bro, listen, they don't want us connecting, man. They don't want you connecting. You hear me? They don't want us connecting. So that's why they made it illegal. It did. Once they start tampering with the genetics of the plant, then they made it illegal. So now it's legal. They didn't tamper with the genetics. So they're like, oh, yeah, we figured out a way how to take out certain things out the plant so that they can't connect. This unlocks certain files. Y'all, although we laughing and I'm joking, I'm using shit as an example because I'm serious to show you how deep this shit go, boy. This shit is cosmic, man. But if you don't know that, we were just smoking weed. Just like this. Check this out. If you smoke this weed and you don't do shit, you're going to be sitting there like this. Like, if I ain't got shit to do with my day and I just smoke this, I'm gonna be sitting here like this. Just stuck. So it's what you do with it. So guess what? Now you could take that and go scientific on your own. Now you get creative. Well, you get creative from that point on your own. Like, he got a point. Whatever I apply myself to, if I hit the weed, I'm going to get an advantage. You are. You're going to tap into certain levels. It's a plant. It's a plant. Y'all see this shit? This shit real, boy. We really do shit like this. Like, this shit is going on right there. Like, they scrapping some more shit. We really move like this. A lot of this has to do, like, when they showing you this, I'm going to save it for when I do the review and all that. You know what I'm saying? I got a lecture coming upon it. But you see this? Like, all this they showing you in the movie. Look at that. All of that. Who you think that's about? Man, who you think that's about, man? They don't want you to connect. That's why they made it legal. How alcohol not... First off, what is cannabis called, y'all? Cannabis is called what? What is it? It's called a drug. It's called a drug. Somebody said that girl on that fast as hell. And so are you. And so are you. Now, imagine if you could believe that you that fast. What you think will happen? You could do that. But you got to access those files. And right now, all the solar flares pouring onto the planet. This is what we, this the energy we in right now. Listen, a lot of y'all already can do this shit and you don't even know it because you ain't tried it. The energy been on the planet since we came into the new year. You feel me? Like, just because I'm not sitting there talking about it every single day, I've already talked to you about it. The energy is already here. The energy here, it's about you tapping into it. How the fuck you gonna know? A lot of y'all sitting there saying, like, oh, that girl fast as hell. Or he's shooting beams out his eyes. Well, have you went in nature and tried to see if you can do this shit? Because you'll be shocked to see what you can do. Because I know what I could do. Because I go into nature and do it. This is what I'm telling you. The energy already here, man. This shit is here, man. All you gotta do is just try. All you got to do is just try. Anything you see motherfuckers doing in these little movies, oh, okay, well, let me go try to do it. Let me see if that's even possible. Let me go try to do that. Let me go see if it's possible. You're not even trying, so how do you know? You ain't trying nothing. You don't really know. See what you, be real, but I mean, have I sat in front of some water yet and tried to see if I can move it with my mind? Have I went out there and tried to, you ain't tried. You just sitting there like waiting for some shit to happen. It's already in you. But, like I was saying about this cannabis, they don't want us to connect. This is deep. This is way deeper than you think. And notice how they made alcohol is not even considered a drug. Alcohol is not considered a drug. This is considered a drug. But alcohol actually kills people, man. We ain't never killed nobody. It ain't a nigga who ever overdosed off of no weed. If they did, he lying. And if he did overdose, somebody put something on the fucking weed. I'm talking about weed itself. You can't find a motherfucker ever died off weed, nigga. I don't know about you, but this is really nigga, we look like we dead off the weed. Nigga might have looked dead off the weed. Hey, you don't know a motherfucker. Nigga, you lying. I don't even want to read comment, nigga. Somebody, because you know somebody go like, my uncle, cousin, Jamaica, niece, daddy. Yes, I do. If I want to be a motherfucker, I want to be stabbed out. You know what I'm saying? Somebody, you know how it be, y'all. Some woman. Well, actually, I do know. Nah, real shit. On Lil Dave and them grave. Then nigga put it on Lil Dave grave and be lying. That's the whole thing. You lying like a motherfucker on Lil Dave grave. You talking about, on Lil Dave grave, my cousin Lamika, baby daddy friend, best friend, JoJo from across the street. They died. They daddy died off weed. No, he didn't. Why is you lying? You just want to say something to say it in the comments. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, like real life, you don't know no motherfucker died off no weed, man. You know what I'm saying? Nigga might have looked dead off the weed. Nigga, that will look dead all day. Nigga look dead off the weed. You hear me? But a nigga, shit, niggas ain't dying. We go to sleep. We get hungry. You feel me? That's all that's going to happen, nigga. That's it, nigga. You gonna laugh. Your mouth might get dry. That's as worse as it's getting, nigga. You smoke too much, your teeth might start getting yellow. Nigga, after that, nigga, it ain't getting no better than that, nigga. You know what I'm saying? And if you smoke and you eat off the, if you get too many munchies off smoking, you go gain a lot of weight. And if you don't like to eat, because some people like to get high and they don't like to eat. They like to enjoy their high. So you'll get skinny. Either you're going to get skinny off the weed or you're going to gain weight. Ain't nobody dying, though, G. You can't find one motherfucker in America with 3 Ks, nigga, that's going to tell you that. Nigga, I ain't never got no accident off none of that. Ain't none of that going on off no weed. Nigga, I ain't never been driving and crashed. What was wrong? Oh, he was high off the gas. Nah, niggas ain't. Now, off the yak? Niggas get off the yak and slap, they wrap they shit around. Poles, what you talking about? Nigga get off the yak and lose they mind. I used to drink, get off that dark lick. I want to fight everybody in the club, nigga. Littlest nigga in the club. I'm trying to scrap, though. I ain't trying to hear nothing. We got to see it. That's why I stopped drinking dark liquor. I learned that shit when I was like 19. Shit, I remember we went out west one time. I started a whole fight. Got my whole motherfucking head bust. Got me and the guys fucked up. Because the guys go still ride with me. You know how that go. Your guys go ride. Your real guys go ride with you. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I ain't drinking no more. I was in the wrong, though. You know what I'm saying? The guys had to pull me up like, G, you was in the wrong, though, G. Like, we in the spot. We had a house party out west. I'm off the, I was off the Paul Masson. This one, I was drinking Paul Masson. I just like to tell y'all about the lower me so I can help the streets out there. Because, motherfucker, listen, y'all. I'm not chasing the people that's already woke, man. They woke, so they going to feel it. I'm talking about, I got to get y'all that ain't woke yet to let y'all know I wasn't always like this. Listen, we was drunk out west in Chicago at a party out west. Off Central Park. I think it was